Hello everyone, how are you today? I'm Dr. Paramjeet and you're watching Dr. Education. Welcome to my channel again. And as you know, I make videos about health and healthcare, and all my videos are directly referenced from the internationally accepted US National Medical Library, and therefore you can trust this information. And today I'm going to talk about hair loss. That's what you've been asking me repeatedly. So here we are with the first hair loss video. And today I'm going to discuss what exactly is hair loss, what are the symptoms, the causes, the treatment, and lastly, I'll give you some tips to take care of your hair. So let's start. If you want to know about health and have health concerns, then subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. You'll be notified about all upcoming videos. First of all, let's break the myth. Everyone loses hair. Everyone. And it is normal to lose about 50 to 100 hairs every day. It's normal. So if you're finding a few hairs in your comb, it's normal. 100 hairs per day is normal, up to 100. So, but if you see bald patches or lots of thinning, that may be hair loss. That may be indications of hair loss. And there are many causes of hair loss. Women may notice hair loss after giving birth. People under a lot of stress can notice hair loss. Some diseases and medicines can have hair loss as side effects. And most common cause of hair loss are medical conditions. And the most common one is hereditary hair loss. Hereditary. So hair loss, as you know, is also called alopecia. Alopecia. The other names of hair losses are male pattern baldness, female pattern baldness, androgenic alopecia. So all these are names of hair loss. Luckily, most causes of hair loss can actually be stopped or treated. Anyone who is troubled with hair loss should see a dermatologist, a skin specialist. And these are doctors who specialize in treating your skin, hair, and nails. Hair loss may cause gradual hair thinning, or it can lead to bald patches or even complete baldness. Now, I'm giving some photos here which will help you identify what type of hair loss you might be having. Now, this is alopecia areata. This is alopecia areata, and this disease can actually cause complete hair loss in otherwise normal people. This is hereditary hair loss in women. Hereditary hair loss causes thinning that begins in the center of the scalp. So this is hereditary hair loss in women. And this one here is traction alopecia. Traction alopecia is because of hairstyles. Hairstyles that constantly pull on hair on the scalp can cause this type of hair loss. This is also typically seen in Sikh people, in Punjabis, because we basically have a traction on the head and therefore we might have traction alopecia. Let me give you a few more examples of alopecia areata. Some people might lose their eyelashes, and hair loss can actually occur anywhere in the body in alopecia areata. And just like that, the disease can often cause hair loss in a round patch. So there is something called as trichotillomania. Trichotillomania is basically a psychological condition which causes the people to pull on their own hair until it comes out. So something looks like that. That's something like this, trichotillomania. So a lot of causes, the different types of hair loss are there which needs to be diagnosed. So depending upon them are the causes. And the question arises, who gets hair loss and why? Now, millions of people actually experience hair loss. Some of them see that hair actually regrows without doing anything. Others actually need treatment to help them regrow hair. And sometimes, no matter what you do, hair will not regrow. So it's not something which is predictable. Time will tell. But to find out what is possible, you should see a doctor, dermatologist. So if we talk about the reason for hair loss, there are many. When hair loss begins suddenly, the cause may be due to an illness, diet, medicine, or hormonal changes like childbirth. If hair loss is gradual and becomes more noticeable with each passing year, the person may be having hereditary hair loss. Certain hair care practices can also cause noticeable hair loss. So let's talk about certain problems why you can have hair loss. So first is hereditary baldness, hereditary thinning, also called as androgenic alopecia. This is basically the most common type of hair loss, and it affects men as well as women. Many people, millions of people, are suffering from this problem all over the world. And men have hereditary hair loss. They often get a receding hairline. They also get a receding hairline. And many men can see bald patches, especially on the top of the head. Women, on the other hand, tend to keep their hairline, but they see noticeable hair thinning. Thinning of hair is not usually seen in men. It is rarely seen. And same way, a receding hairline or a bald patch are rarely seen in women. The reason for this differentiation are basically mostly unknown, but hormones play a big role. So then second type of hair loss is alopecia areata. The examples are given before, just like the researchers believe that this is basically an autoimmune disease. Autoimmune, as I've already explained, is when your body's immune system attacks itself, right? In that case, the body attacks your own hair, and this causes smooth, round patch of hair loss on the scalp or other areas on the body. And people with alopecia areata are often in very good health otherwise. And most people see that their hair can actually regrow. So dermatologists treat people with this disorder to help the hair regrow more quickly. Then there is something called as cicatrical alopecia, scarring basically. This is a rare disease which develops in otherwise healthy people, and the disease destroys a person's hair follicle itself, and scar tissue forms where the follicle was there. So the hair cannot regrow. The treatment tries to stop the inflammation which destroys the hair follicle, but still, if the follicles are destroyed, you cannot regrow them. Then there is something called as central centrifugal cicatrical alopecia. This type of hair loss occurs most often in women of African descent, and it begins at the center of the skull. And as it progresses, the hair loss radiates out from the center of the skull, affected scalp becomes smooth and shiny. The hair loss can be very slow or rapid, and when the hair loss occurs quickly, the person may be having tingling, burning, pain, or even itching on the scalp. The treatment is basically to again help regrow the hair if scarring has not occurred. If scarring has occurred, again, the hair follicle is destroyed and you cannot grow hair in that area. Then there are certain diseases, medical condition, underlying medical conditions, which there are about 30 diseases like thyroid disease, anemia, and many others, which can actually cause hair loss or speed your hair loss. So by treating these diseases, hair loss can actually be stopped or reversed. So you should find out in a generalized health checkup if you are having any medical disease. And so apart from all these medical conditions, even significant hair loss can occur after an illness, acute illness, like a major surgery, a high grade fever, severe infections, even the flu can also lead to significant hair loss. Your doctor, dermatologist, may call this type of hair loss as a telogen effluvium. Sounds like a Harry Potter magic code, right? Then as you all must be knowing, cancer treatment, radiation therapy or chemotherapy can actually cause hair loss, but this type of hair loss is often temporary, and it can cause great distress during the treatment to the patient's mind. If you have a fungal ringworm infection, ringworm is not a worm, it's a fungal infection, and it is a contagious disease, very common in children, and without effective treatment, it can cause balding. It can lead to significant hair loss. Then we've already discussed trichotillomania, in which there is a psychological problem and people actually pull out their hair, and then they can actually feel or compelled to pull out their eyelashes, nose hair, ear hairs, or other hairs of the body also. So these are the diseases, medical conditions which can lead to hair loss. Then there are certain hormonal and stressful situations like giving birth. After giving birth, some women have noticeable hair loss, and this is because of falling estrogen levels. This hair loss is caused because of falling estrogen levels, and this is temporary. After a few months, these women see a very nice hair regrow. So that's what is there, and this is often called hair loss in new moms. So you don't have to worry about it, it will grow, just have a good nutrition, and that's all that is needed. Then menopause. Hair loss is very commonly seen during menopausal stage, the transition stage, and this loss is also temporary. Hair will regrow with time. But of course, if a woman is 40 years of age or older, she should not expect her hair to have that fullness that it did when she was younger. Then there is stress. Experiencing a traumatic event like death of a loved one, divorce, or a breakup can even lead to hair loss. Then the most biggest thing which is there is diet and poor nutrition. One of the biggest key problem here is people trying to lose their weight. Some people see hair loss after losing more than around 15 pounds, around 8 to 10 kgs. If you lose that, you will see a lot of hairs, and this hair loss often appears after 3 to 6 months after losing the weight, and this is very common. But yes, don't worry, this type of hair will regrow without help. Then vitamin A. Too much vitamin A can actually cause hair loss. People can actually get too much of this vitamin by supplements or medicines. If you're taking a lot of vitamin A supplements, then there is too much vitamin, then what happens? Your body stops. But yes, this is also temporary. When you stop taking these vitamins, when your body stops getting too much vitamin, the normal hair will regrow again slowly. Then there is protein. When the body does not get enough protein, so your body tries to ration the protein it actually gets now. The limited protein is used wherever it is actually necessary. And protein is required for hair growth, hair buildup. So your body first shuts down hair growth. And therefore the problem here is not hair loss. Here the hair is not growing. So therefore you slowly feel there is hair loss. About 2 to 3 months after a person does not eat enough protein, you can see this kind of hair loss, and eating more protein will actually stop the hair loss. In this case, eggs, meat, fish are a good source. Milk are a good source of protein. Vegetarians can actually get more proteins by adding nuts, seeds, and even beans to their diet, and lean protein can be added. I have a different video on lean protein. Just type lean protein by Dr. Education on YouTube and you'll find a video. Then iron. Not getting enough iron can actually lead to hair loss. Good vegetarian sources of iron are fortified cereals, soya beans, pumpkin seeds, white beans, lentils, spinach, and there are oysters and organ meats in non-vegetarian options, which are very good source of iron, organ meats. Then eating disorders are there. When a person has an eating disorder, hair loss is common. Anorexia, which is basically not eating enough, or bulimia, which is vomiting after eating. If you vomit intentionally after eating just to stay thin, or you don't eat at all, then you can have a hair loss because of various reasons. Let's like explain protein deficiency, vitamin deficiency, weight loss, right? So these are the reasons. Then coming on to medicines. What kind of medicines can actually lead to hair loss? There are some. First is some type of blood thinners, high dose vitamin A, medicines that treat arthritis, depression, gout, heart problems, high blood pressure, birth control pills. Some women who take these birth control pills see hair loss. Sometimes the hair loss begins when a woman stops taking the pill. Women who gets hair loss often have hereditary hair loss also. Then there are anabolic steroids. Steroids taken to build muscle and improve aesthetic performance can actually lead to hair loss. Then coming on to hair care. If you have a problem in your hair care routine, then also you can have hair loss. Your hairstyle and even sometimes the products which you use can cause hair loss. If you talk about products, bleaching frequently or permanent. Frequently, temporary bleaching or permanent bleaching can actually cause hairs to break. So regular or improper use of dyes, gels, hair relaxers, hair sprays can actually cause hair breakage. Dermatologist recommends limiting the use of these type of hair products. Less use often means less hair breakage and therefore less hair loss. So limit as least as you need. So there is no standard safe limit here, so make it as less as possible. Then blow drying, flat iron and other devices. Frequent use of these kind of blow dryers tend to damage hair. High heat from these blow dryers or can actually or flat irons can actually boil the water in the hair shaft, leaving the hair brittle. So it just breaks down. It's very prone to breakage. So that's why your doctors will recommend, dermatologist recommends you to allow the hair to air dry. It's very important to allow your hairs to air dry and then style your hair when it is dry. That's very important. And it is also recommended to limit the use of flat irons. These are like the straightening irons which are used with high heat, or even the curling iron. These actually damage your hair. If you have even a little hair loss, stop taking these, stop using these, stop using these things. Then hairpins, yes, hairpins, clips and rubber bands. When used, if you use them very tightly, hairpins, clips and rubber bands can also break hairs. Then hairstyles. Years of wearing hair in one style that pulls the hair, such as a ponytail, a crown row, such as a ponytail or a braid, can actually cause a type of hair loss, which is actually called as traction alopecia, which we saw earlier. Then there is washing, dyeing, dyeing and combing can actually cause hair loss. Too much washing, too much combing, too much brushing, right? More than 100 strokes per day is too much. More than 100 strokes per day is too much. So that can cause hair loss. Rubbing or wet hair. Rubbing wet hair with a towel, is not good. It can cause hair breakage. Brushing or combing wet hair can also cause breakage, especially in people who are Asian, right? So these are all the possible reasons why you are having hair loss, why you might be having hair loss. So lastly, let's talk about how hair loss is diagnosed and treated by a dermatologist. See, because so many things can cause hair loss, a dermatologist actually has to act like a detective. And they begin with asking a lot of questions, and they will want to know why it started happening, how suddenly it started happening, was it gradual, and what you are doing to help it, or what products you are using. They'll ask you all about your medicines, your medical history, your diet. Like, it's basically like a murder mystery. A slight clue can actually solve the case. So a woman, we may also be asked about her periods of pregnancy, her menopause, even the sex life. Anything is, any small clue can be relevant here. So they also do a very careful examination of your scalp and your hairs, and during the examination they might even pull on your hair. Sometimes the dermatologist needs to pull out hairs to get the necessary evidence, and sometimes the doctors may need to look at the hair on the rest of the body to compare and see whether there is actually too little or too much hair in other areas, or whether the hair texture is different, etc. So sometimes the evidence lies in your scalp itself. The dermatologist may remove a piece of your scalp. This is called a scalp biopsy, and in that case it can be quickly and safely performed in office visit itself, and it is essential sometimes to solve the case. Sometimes blood tests are necessary. So because so many things can cause hair loss, it takes time to find out the reason, and you might need to come for a few appointments. So why and how? So that's how we diagnose and how basically you treat it. So then how do you treat it? See, just as there are many causes, there are many treatments for hair loss, and dermatologists recommend treating hair loss as early as possible. You need to start early. Early means before you lose a lot of hair. Hair loss is harder to treat when the person has lost most of the hairs, and it's very difficult to actually fill the area again. One or more of the following treatments. So what are the treatment options? So first is, there are two types of treatments. First is what you can actually get without a prescription. The second is which needs a prescription medicine. So these are the medicines which we are talking about. First and very commonly used are minoxidil. Minoxidil is basically a medicine which is applied to the scalp, to the skin area. Minoxidil is applied to the scalp, and it can stop hairs from getting thinner and stimulate hair growth on the scalp. And this is the only hair regrowth product which is approved by the FDA for men and women. So this product can be used, and your doctor might use or ask you to use this with other treatments like laser devices, like brushes, combs, and other handheld devices that emit laser light, which might stimulate hair growth. And these devices might make your hair look more youthful in some people, because these products are classified as medical devices. These products do not undergo rigorous testing for medicines, like just like medicines undergo. So long-term effectiveness and safety of these devices are not known. Then there are prescription medicines. First is finasteride. Finasteride is used to treat hair loss in men, and it comes in a pill form and helps slow hair loss in 88% of men. It helps stimulate the hair regrowth in many men, almost 66%. Finasteride works by stopping the body from making a male hormone called DHT, dihydrotestosterone. So finasteride stops DHT and therefore stimulates hair growth all over the body. It is used in men because in women it will lead to hairs all over the body. So women don't want that. Then corticosteroids. Corticosteroids is if a hair loss is caused because of inflammation in the body, then your doctor might even inject a medicine. Inject a corticosteroid injection into your scalp, and this can actually help stop the inflammation and help the person who has alopecia areata. So corticosteroid is actually different from anabolic steroids. We will be making a video on corticosteroids as well as anabolic steroids very soon, so keep following for that. Then there are some procedures. The type of procedure that a doctor will recommend depending is the type of procedure that you require will the type of procedure that a doctor recommends will depend upon how much hair you have lost. And hair transplant is there, in which skin on the scalp that has good hair growth is removed and transplanted to the area on the scalp that needs hair. So that is hair transplant. Then there is scalp reduction. Scalp reduction means the bald scalp is surgically removed and the hair bearing scalp is brought closer together to reduce the balding. Scalp reduction surgery can be performed alone or in conjunction with hair transplant. Then there is scalp expansion. Devices are inserted. In this case, devices are inserted into the scalp for about 3 to 4 weeks to stretch the skin. The procedure may be performed before scalp reduction to make the scalp more lax, so that we can actually reduce it. And it can also be performed solely to stretch the scalp, to stretch the hair bearing areas, which reduces balding. So that is one option. Then there is scalp flaps. In this case, the hair bearing segment of the scalp is surgically moved and placed where the hair is needed. So scalp flap is needed. Then see, hair transplant, the hair is basically skin from the skin is needed, and then there is scalp, whole scalp is removed. Once your doctor knows what kind of hair loss you have, your doctor can tell you what to expect. Sometimes the hair loss does not need treatment, and sometimes the hair will start to regrow on its own. In some cases, changing what you do will stop the hair loss, allowing your hairs to regrow naturally sometimes, but treatment like these are needed to restore the hair. Lastly, as I promised, some tips for managing your hairs. And the best tip is to practice a good hair care routine. Many people are surprised to learn that hairstyles, or even the way they are washing and drying their hairs, contributes to the hair loss, and following the tips can actually I'm going to post a video on how to take care of your hair best. So I'm going to post a video very soon on ideal hair care routine. So wait for that and do watch that. Then the second tip is to not to stop taking any medicine that your doctor has prescribed. Sometimes some medications can cause hair loss, but the doctor might just warn you about them. But don't stop taking medicines without consulting a doctor, because immediately stopping any kind of medicine can actually cause serious side effects. So if you think the medicine is causing hair loss, talk to your doctor who prescribed the medicine. If the medicine is the problem, the doctor might just replace the medicine with another option. Third most important tip is that you need to realize that your hair loss may be temporary. Some things in life cause temporary hair loss. We've discussed so many things like illness, childbirth, stress, And during a very stressful time, your body reacts by causing more hairs than normal to go into the resting phase. For most people, this hair will start to regrow without any help. So don't worry. These types of hair loss mostly are temporary. Then last tip is talk to a dermatologist. Many things can cause hair loss. And if you have a concern about hair loss, go and talk to a skin specialist, dermatologist. They will find out what is wrong with you and what you can expect and how you can get treated. So that's all about hair loss in very utter details. I'm Dr. Paramjeet. I'm not a dermatologist. I'm a physician and cardiologist. I cannot treat your hair loss. I can just guide you. So I am a physician and cardiologist in Yashoda Superspeciality Hospital, Nehru, Nagar, Ghaziabad, Delhi, NCR. And this is my channel where I guide you. So do share this video, send it to everyone, and till next time, stay connected, stay healthy.